Hey guys, Nyxarity here, and welcome to the final episode of Telltale's The Wolf Among Us. It's bound to be exciting.
I mean, your eyes and the teeth, you're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Not really supposed to, I suppose.
Not if I can avoid it.
Yep.
No.
Holly's sister, Lily.
Do you even give a shit about us, the strays?
That's why you can't tell me anything. It's the ribbon, isn't it?
We're destroying the tree.
We are not destroying the tree,
Snow. No!
We're not burning the tree, Snow.
Hey. You're not really gonna send me to the farm, are you? After everything we fucking been through, you don't have the nerve to give me a straight answer.
Ouch.
Oh God, Bigby!
This time was no joke. Eat as many metal shellings as you see fit, but take just one more silver round near your heart. And the only place I'll be visiting you is the morgue.
Thanks, Doc.
Bigby, wait. When you get the Crooked Man, make sure you bring him back alive. He has to stand trial.
Why don't you have a seat, Sheriff? We have a great deal to discuss.
That we do. That we do. Oh, finally, no big long intro scene and then you throw this at me. We're just gonna start off with it. Good. I like it. It's the only way a finale should be handled. However, it does not give me anything to comment on, other than what happened previously. And it basically gave me all of the important things that have happened previously, so, I mean... There, I managed to bullshit my way through that. Episode 5, Cry Wolf.
You've come a long way. You must be tired.
Mm-hmm.
And if my envoys are correct, you haven't had a lot of rest recently. Please, Sheriff, relax for a moment, will you? Do you want a drink? Something to eat? Vivian makes a very nice, very... It's elegant. Really, a carpaccio. It's lobster. Sirloin.
Don't misunderstand the situation here. We are not friends.
Mm-mm.
You're in no position to offer me anything.
On the contrary, Sheriff. And I don't wish to contradict you here, but your initiative and mine have been friendly for a long while now. Ever since I came aboard these shores. You know, Fabletown's been very accommodating of my humble ventures.
Just what are you talking about?
I've just been left in relative peace, I think puts it best. Allowed to live my own way. What do you think you're doing?
He's gonna...
Mr. Wolf is our guest, and I have every intention of cooperating. So don't waste the silver. Sit down, Jersey. Well, Sheriff, for the sake of transparency, why don't you tell us why you're here? It would help settle everyone's nerves, I think.
You forget what happened at the Pudding and Pie? You and your goons tried to kill me!
I'm truly sorry for that whole debacle. It was not my intention to put you or Miss White in any sort of danger.
Mm-hmm.
My wish was merely to take Crane, Sheriff. And as soon as the assignment grew out of control, I put a stop to it.
You sure took your damn time.
It doesn't change what happened to you. And I can only offer my sincerest apologies.
You didn't stop it out of the kindness of your heart. You stopped it because Snow White offered up Crane.
That may have appeared to you to be the case, but I assure you, it wasn't. Mm-hmm. And I hope you believe me when I say, Sheriff, that I sincerely mean to make it up to you. The recent murders that have gotten such attention as of late, I don't relish telling you that they were perpetrated by an employee of mine. It's a very unfortunate bit of business, but I promise you that the matter will be dealt with internally. I just want to settle the issue for you and to assure you that it's over with.
An unfortunate bit of business? You're gonna tell me right now who killed him?
Sheriff, I have complete respect for you and your job. I hope you know that.
No, I don't.
I simply can't divulge that information. You really shouldn't worry yourself. As I said, I've got this under control.
No, I'm gonna deal with it right now.
Yeah, right. What do you think this is? Some kind of negotiation? The man said he'd take care of it. So why don't you take the hint and get out?
I'm already pissed off. You don't want to make it worse.
You think I'm scared of you? You're nothing more
That's
than a...
enough!
I was hoping it wouldn't come to this, but in the interest of preserving our alliance, if you have to know, it was Georgie. However, like I said, I'd be handling the matter if you don't mind.
Georgie.
You got what you wanted, so just...
Sit down. Now.
Yeah, I killed him, so what?
Why?
Why'd you do it? Why kill them? Does it matter?
Yes.
Look, the fact is, George here misinterpreted one of my instructions.
Misinterpreted?
And I want to make things right. So, let's work something out.
What's there to work out? I'm protected, aren't I?
Your protection has limits, and I think you've far exceeded yours. But you could murder someone in cold blood like that.
You fucking asked me to do this!
And then attempt to blame me for it. You will be silent while we discuss what to do with you.
This is right bollocks, sis. You're just gonna let him do this?
Ooh.
So what do you say, Sheriff? Can we discuss terms? You can have Georgie. Consider it a gift. Ensuring our continued cooperation.
I think I'll be taking both of you.
You're not taking me, you fucking punts. What the fuck is this shit? You said you'd cover for us.
For minor infractions, not murder.
Just go with him, Georgie. You're gonna sink us all.
What's wrong with you people? You're really gonna sell him out just like
you
that?
You think I'd give a fuck if I'm the one... Who the shit do you think you fuckers are?
Get the fuck out of here.
I do apologize, Sheriff.
Oh, dear.
But I think it's best if you leave now.
There's no way I'm going with him. Are you kidding me?
Things are about to get unpleasant, and I would rather you weren't here to watch.
You can go join that hall at the bottom of the lake for all I give a shit, but he's not taking me anywhere. I'll roll over on the lot of you before I let that shit happen.
What are you saying?
Yeah, what the fuck?
I already told you. I'm taking both of you in, so let's go.
This could have gone so well. To speak the truth, I've never been a very good mediator. Why negotiate when you can just decide?
Oh, joy.
Did I miss anything good? Well, look at you all fixed up.
Ow! Why is there so much pain? Why is there always so much pain?
Take this!
Oh, jeez.
You're done, Wolf!
Come on, we're pretty much done here.
Oh, jeez.
I'd like to say it was nice knowing you, but I'll be glad to see your insides turned out.
Oh, jeez.
Now! Hold him still!
Well. That looks painful.
eyes.
Ow. What? What? Oh, jeez. Okay. Well.
Oh, God.
That's the thing that happened.
This way.
Sorry, Jersey, but you brought that on yourself.
I've left them all in shambles.
Well, not my fault.
Ooh, shit!
I know. I know.
My bumper. Oh dear. Okie dokie. Oh my, oh dear. Button, joystick, thing. Oh, this is fun. Hit by a car one too many times tonight.
Fuck.
Come on.
Fuck it.
Look, clothes. And they just happen to be my size and the exact clothes that I usually wear. Never mind where I got the shoes. I didn't realize that that was Crooked Man's car.
Come on.
Oh, well.
We can't stay here.
Oh, my.
Hang on. I need a minute.
Okay.
Wow. That did quite a bit of damage.
Hello, Bigby. I ought to come to your senses. Crooked Man's the one you want. But of course, you're too much of an idiot to see that. Or maybe you just like me too much to let me go.
Yeah.
That it, Sheriff? I had to say goodbyes first.
Should you really be moving in your condition?
Please, Sheriff. Haven't you done enough? Look at him. He's dying.
Vivian, you don't know what you're doing.
I'm trying to help you here.
Mm. Just leave it alone.
He could kill you. You're okay with that?
There's no changing his mind now. Sheriff's always right, isn't he?
But he's wrong. Bigby, stop for a second. Please.
I'm listening.
It isn't his fault.
He's a murderer. Faith and Lily, he's the reason they're dead.
Look, I know he made a few mistakes. We all have.
What?
He made sure they couldn't talk with those damn ribbons, and then he killed them. You're wearing one yourself. Doesn't that bother you even a little, knowing that man murdered...
Of course it does. Those girls...
So it's all my fucking fault, then. You're gonna throw me to the fucking wolf, too? You know I didn't have a goddamn choice. What the fuck? I did what I had to! You can't fucking blame me for that.
Look.
Why'd you do it then, huh? If it's not your fault, then what the fuck happened?
Why is everybody so angry?
Faith and the others tried to pull a run on us. And as you can imagine, the Crooked Man wasn't too thrilled.
Okay.
But of course, the big boss didn't want to get his fucking hands dirty. So he told me to take care of it. You think I don't know what that means? Either I do what he says or I'm the one getting dealt with. So I fucking killed him. And I'd do it again. Because it's not my fault. The Crooked Man gave the order. He told me to kill them. And then he fucking sold me out.
That's true.
Both of you can go rot in hell.
Georgie.
You think I'm the one to fucking blame?
That's not what I meant. I was just trying to...
I know what you were trying to do. You're trying to lay this all on me. You and everyone else.
You're not thinking. Georgie, you know that's not what I meant.
Then what was that? He calls me a murderer and you're gonna fucking take his side? Go ahead and kill me then. But he won't bring back Lily or Faith. He won't free your friend Narissa. And I'm just the sap taking the fall for the whole thing.
Yep.
It must be so easy being you. Just come in here and blame me for all this shit. Job's done, right? George is the bad guy. It's all his fucking fault.
Well, I was trying not to, but it didn't really give me that option.
But what was I supposed to do? You don't know what it's like, Bigby. How could you know? At the end of the day, you're just like him. Coming here, talking about options, like it was that simple. I would have lost everything. All of it. So maybe I did have a choice, but it wasn't fucking worth it. What would you have me do? Kill her?
Georgie, don't.
It was them or Vivian. So you tell me, if free Lily meant she had to die. Do you still think I had a fucking choice?
What are you talking about?
This is the original. The girl with the ribbon. I'm sure you've heard the stories. Couldn't take it off. Couldn't talk about it. She used her little purple ribbon to make more of them. To keep our girls quiet. To ensure absolute discretion.
You promised you wouldn't.
All that magic is connected to this little thing. You remove hers, and the spell's broken. They're all free. But you know what happens to her? The same thing that happened to Faith. So don't you come in here and tell me I fucked up.
What the hell, Georgie? We were supposed to look out for each other. I trusted you.
You can't fucking blame me. You're not innocent here either.
I know that. But did it have to be like this? You sold me out.
Welcome to the club, then.
Yeah, no kidding.
I understand. Nobody was supposed to die. When we built this place, it was just a stupid idea. A gimmick. Discretion is our guarantee. That's how it started, anyway. This was supposed to be our place. We were going to be in charge for once, and nobody would try to control us or use us. That was the point. Then the Crooked Man showed up, and everything just turned to shit.
So, do you get it now? Why I couldn't just... If you still think it's so fucking simple, then you do it. Go right ahead. Kill her, then.
What are you doing?
Break the spell. Save the fucking day!
Stop it!
We'll find another way. She doesn't have to die. Maybe the witches
don't
can...
Don't talk about me like I'm not even here. Please. You think this is hard for you? My life is such a fucking burden on your conscience. Don't I get a say? It's my life.
You're right. It's your life.
I know what I've done.
Wait.
I'm sick of everyone thinking that they can just do what they want with my life. I thought it would be different here. But it's all the fucking
same. Vivian, I didn't mean...
Do you think I wanted to be this person? What I did to Faith and Lily? To all of them?
Vivian, wait!
Every day I have to look Gwen and Hans in the eye and pretend I don't care. I have to forget what I've done to them. What I took away from them.
Jeez.
I look at Nerissa and I hate myself.
Vivian!
I can't pretend anymore.
What are you doing?
Vivian! Don't! Vivian! No! Fuck!
Well, okay. No, no, that no, happened.
No. Why'd you have to do that, Vivian? Vivian! Shit!
Nope. Mm-mm. Okay.
Vivian, I didn't fucking mean it. I was just...
Just everybody's dying left, right, and sideways there.
Oh, fuck!
Get up.
Really?
Get up!
Don't think so, Bigby. I'm gonna die here. I think we both know that. Just make sure you give the crooked man the same treatment when you find him. Really fuck him up for me, all right? For both of us.
He's gonna get worse. Don't worry.
Good. Old foundry by the river, all right? Shepherd Metalworks. He'll be there. Fucking asshole. You wanna finish me off now? Or do you plan to kick me around a little first? Rip my limbs off one by one? That's what you wanna do, right?
That's not who I am.
Prove it then. No more games, all right? We both know how this ends. Just make it quick.
Oh.
I don't know what I did.
Fine. Only to end your suffering. Jeez. Okie dokie then. All the tough decisions coming out now, aren't we? I mean, in the end, he's the one that came at me with a knife. How's it going?
Of course.
Knock, knock. Anybody home? No? Okay. Oh, wonderful. A light. Lovely place you got here.
Baby wolf.
Looks like a real screaming death trap.
The big bad wolf. You used to be something.
Oh my. Okie dokie. What's with this accusation going on here?
They used to fear you.
They Wonderful.
Hide anywhere their small shivering bodies would fit.
Lovely.
Silver.
The big bad wolf.
Having fun? Ow.
It's about time you showed up.
I had to take care of some things first.
Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate.
Of course.
You finished here.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Cut this shit out!
Didn't your mother ever teach you manners? Or was she too busy fucking whatever breeze drifted through town? Oh, come on! Is that the best you can do?
Ouch. How do you just go flitting through dimensions like that? Really? Well, aren't you a bundle of joy? Oh yeah, that's fun. Okay. So this is a thing. Ouch. You're a bundle of fun. Jeez. Ouch. Ouch. Oh, joy. I fall. I was so busy button mashing. Didn't even notice. Oh dear. Oh yeah, really looking forward to this. Creek crack, okay. Oh dear, there's many of them. Well, this look ain't looking so great. Oh, Bigby, you beautiful beast. Ow. Blow. Nice. Get him, Bigby. Get him! Sounded kind of painful. Look at that, a nice little pile of clothes for you. Well, Mr. Crooked Man, did you like what you saw?
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds 6 rounds of specially designed silver bullets. Now, I may not be the best shot, but I can guarantee that at least one bolt will meet its mark, and you'll find yourself rolling on the floor in agony, unable to heal yourself. Without Swinehart to save you, you'll die. Is that reason enough for you? Before you do anything...
Yeah, okay.
I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she?
Yeah.
And that's what I want.
That's right. But what happens to you once you get there is a different story.
I'm not quite finished. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial.
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Why don't you let me worry about that?
No, I want an explanation.
There's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand.
No.
I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
If you're not a killer, then what are you?
I'm a businessman, not a killer.
Mm-hmm.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community.
Fine, let's go.
I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth? Or do you just want to look like the hero?
This is about justice. I'm the sheriff. I have to do what's right. Two people were murdered.
And you know who did it. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in. But you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going?
All right, let's go. Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind.
I mind.
What do you
say? I mind.
Fine.
No, none for you.
I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
You're under arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
I know. But we have to do something. Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Really?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to...
Hi.
He's back.
The crooked man.
Thank God.
Motherfucker.
It's okay, Gren. It's okay.
Are you okay? It's been hours.
Well, you didn't make it easy.
What happened?
It doesn't matter. He's here.
Don't concern yourself with the details.
We can talk about it later. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just glad you made it back in one piece.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes! What are you waiting for?
You murderer!
You killed Lily!
Oh my God, not everybody at once.
You're a fucking crook!
You should be ashamed.
Order! I will have order!
Your attention. Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The crooked man is charged with the murder of Faith and...
As I already informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Bourdieu who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie.
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White.
Georgie may have killed them, but you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well,
yes.
Where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yes, Sheriff. Where is that rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Well, where is he?
Georgie was a victim of this psycho, too. He was pushed into the whole thing, and now he's dead.
He's what?
Dead. So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no
That doesn't change anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for.
Uh-huh.
And
I was told I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you'd wait a moment.
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
Yes, actually, I do.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolf.
Mm-hmm.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
No.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I had nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Uh-huh.
Bullshit! Like hell you
did. Stop the charade. We know you're involved.
Come on, it's obvious.
Everyone just shut up for a minute. You wanted a chance to talk. Well, go ahead.
What?
We all know he's guilty. What the fuck does he need to speak for?
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government and, most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death, upon which your body will be committed to the witching
Where it fucking belongs.
That's
so
right.
Let's get
but
on with it
But we promised you a chance to defend yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And I won't rob you of that right.
What the
You're
fuck?
Really
this
going for
is
that
about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
Mm-hmm. I'm not sure I'd uncuff him.
This is ridiculous.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Okay.
Oh, are you gonna get to your point or what?
Seriously.
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees.
Mm-hmm.
I had nothing to do with
it. This is fucking bullshit!
He's always been a bit of a powder keg.
If you were so offended by it, why'd you cover it up then? If it had nothing to do with you and your shit, then why'd you try to protect him for so long?
What cover up? I never made any attempt to hide Georgie's criminal activity from you. I learned of it myself
for
recently.
For fuck's sake.
Uh-huh.
Do you actually believe this bullshit?
No.
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
Yeah, and your goons attacked me. Did you forget that part?
They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I protected them.
Bullshit.
You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
I really hope you're going somewhere with this.
I see. You want to cut right to the point. I can appreciate that. Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that. Hired help.
Mm-hmm.
I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
You're not serious. I know what you do to people. I've seen it firsthand. What you did to Faith. The way you manipulated her. Do you really think any of those girls were free? Do you really think Faith wanted to...
I'm sorry that your wife came to me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my best judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Uh-huh.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us, how you kept us all
you
in
forget
line.
It was not me who put you in that position. You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant.
Just
With
a smidge.
Abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
Wasn't I?
Crane was the one who let this town go to the fucking dogs. The guy who was in your pocket, remember?
Really? What about Auntie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself.
So...
And what did they do?
You did one good thing in a sea of disgusting horridness.
We refused.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you want that?
I know. Snow made a mistake.
I have very good reasons for asking you to
I'm trying to defend you, shut up.
She was working with Crane and the Crooked Man.
It wasn't her fault.
Seriously.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with the Crooked Man.
Yeah.
We've made some mistakes. I've... made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town. And that may not always be clear right away, but I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can. But I can promise to always have your best interests at heart.
We didn't get you into this situation. He did.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you. Exploiting your hope for a better life.
Mm-hmm.
You would go to him for help, and he would take that weakness and add it to his strength. And if things didn't fall exactly his way, someone would die. And I'm just sorry it took us this long to realize what he'd been doing.
Yep.
You're right.
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over, and those girls will have their justice.
Very good, very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you! Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard?
Yeah.
Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's... history.
What are you talking about?
I destroyed things, I didn't lie.
Snow?
And what about your history? All you've done to this fucking town?
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just...
Of course it's right. This man tormented all of you, for profit. Georgie killed him.
Let me make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course. Where are you going with this?
If I'm to blame for George's mistakes, shouldn't Miss White be held accountable for Bigby's actions as well?
Like what?
How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody?
I didn't do shit!
He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right.
Did you think we'd all just let that go?
That was Bluebeard, not me.
He was a murder suspect.
Besides,
doesn't change the fact
Crane
I didn't
was
know
the
it.
Deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employees' behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
Is completely different.
I
we all
did not order those two girls dead. It simply happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
this
crimes.
Isn't right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you.
Listen, I know...
The laws apply when we need them.
Everyone calm down. This isn't
the reason we're here. I mean, a certain level of privilege should be afforded to
them. This is how it's always been.
This is what I'm talking about. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since, which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be the...
Bigby! Miss White!
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath?
What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
Okay.
Yeah, kind of in the middle of something.
Bluebeard.
Of course. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't...
Just shut up! You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
No, actually. She kind of did that to herself.
Be quiet.
Vivian wanted you freed from the ribbons. She took her own life.
I'm sorry, I don't think I...
Nerissa! My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily...
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Ooh.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty.
Good enough for me?
Me too.
So that's it. Right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves.
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
What did you expect to happen here? You're getting what you deserve.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence. We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's not good enough.
There will be more if he isn't stopped.
I don't care. So we get rid of him.
We can send
everyone. Again with the everyone at once.
Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment. So I think
this is going nowhere.
Vote.
Someone needs to make a decision.
We should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right. Nobody can agree on anything. What about Bigby?
Majority.
What about him? He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
Oh, God, no. Not that responsibility.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine. Are you sure? This isn't how
it's... what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Enjoy.
So,
just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff.
Oh, God.
Do what you think is right.
Teach him a fucking lesson.
No.
He has to die.
We can lock him
just
away.
Just fucking get rid of him.
Not this.
Oh, Jesus. Okay. Nope, 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 nope. Whoops. I slipped.
There you are. I hope You all remember this moment. Think of me when you try to sleep. Finish it, Sheriff.
Please, we can still...
End it already.
Nope, you know, okay.
Just between us, I was gonna let you live. But now,
you're going to miss me.
No.
No, I won't.
For Lily and Faith.
Yes, another one of us to erase from the books.
I was very seriously considering just locking him up. But I mean, if you wanted it to be that way, it's that way now. Can I finally get some sleep?
Oh, hi. Sheriff Bigby. Great, great to see you. I don't know if you remember me.
I know who you are, Flycatcher. You've worked at the Woodlands for how many years now?
I think I've lost count. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. Well, I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay, great.
This fucking line.
Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Really?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
If we've got this much stuff in an apartment building, shouldn't we just own the apartment building?
I'm going! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
And carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit! You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Yeah, no kidding.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day.
I tried.
Shit! Just go grab that, would you? Sorry about all this. I tried to help. Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance, but Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway.
Come on, Colin.
I'm walking, all right? Calm down.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby, I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
I tried, I did.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... If you could bring it to her?
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle.
It's
That's
pretty.
A big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
It is pretty.
That's everybody.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there. And they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
I'm sorry, TJ. But, look on the bright side, okay? There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Even in the daytime.
You won't have to worry about the Mundy seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on. It won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ. Are you still mad at me?
Would it change your mind?
No.
You got another one of those? How about a smoke for the road? Thanks, Bigby. Always a gentleman, aren't you, Bigby?
I try.
I guess I'll see you around. Stay out of trouble, okay? If you even can.
I can't make any promises.
Yeah, me neither.
I'd just like to know if Colin apparently saying keeps coming goodbye. Back, how he's not seen. How does he make it all the way up here every single time?
Hi.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh. Yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to...
It's okay. I get it.
Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily.
Okay.
Not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence?
Narissa, just tell me what happened.
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
So you sold them out?
No.
Yes.
Yes. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man.
Of course he did.
Then... Oh, God.
I'm bad at comforting, apparently.
I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason.
No, dear.
And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this? Not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough. I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith... I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her. Just hoping that maybe if I couldn't save them.
So, that piece of fabric I found near there, that was you?
Yeah. I cut my leg trying to get over the fence.
So you started all this?
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that.
Yeah.
When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade, like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us.
It's going to be different now, I promise. Things like that won't happen anymore. Not while I'm around.
You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. It seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her.
For anyone.
I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days. Look, Bigby. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you, none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would.
True.
You knew when to show mercy, and you brought justice to this town. Finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was. So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing.
Thanks.
You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good here.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you.
Aw, thanks. I tried.
You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
Everybody keeps saying that.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too.
What hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom?
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for. I'll see you around. Wolf.
Okay. I'm not sure what conclusion we just came to. Oh dear. Yeah. And Georgie's suffering. Yep, okay. Okay. Well, that does it for The Wolf Among Us. Season 1, I guess. There were rumors that there was supposed to be a Season 2 out eventually. I'm still hoping for that because this is like the biggest cliffhanger ever that I want solved. So if it ever does come to fruition, it will be here on the channel as soon as I'm able to get it up. But anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and leave it a like. Comment down below on what conclusion you think that Bigby came to at that very last moment that led to us either letting her go or going after her. Part of me kind of wonders if the ribbons are still a thing and it wasn't actually Vivian that was the original ribbon girl, or if, you know, maybe even like Faith somehow glamored herself to look like Nerissa, and Nerissa's the one that ended up dead. And because we never found the lower half of her body, the glamour tube was still on her, maybe? I don't know. Anyway, lots of things to think about. So thank you guys again so much. Go ahead and subscribe for more great content. This is Nyxarity signing off. See you guys next time. Bye-bye.